I've missed you.
So what are you gonna do about it?
Here's the full story of Beck and Jade. Jade and Beck were the top couple at Hollywood Arts. So Jade wasn't gonna let some new girl touch her boyfriend.
Dude, why are you rubbing my boyfriend? I spilled coffee on his...
Get away from him!
Relax.
Jade's jealous fury kinda backfired because Beck went and did this right in front of her.
Kiss me.
Let's do it.
Okay, he totally could have said, let's not kiss. Or literally anything else that started with the letter L, just saying. But Beck and Jade's back and forth is actually pretty cute sometimes.
I want coffee.
What's the magic word?
Get me some coffee. Please.
Actually, the magic word was lotion, but I'll accept your please because you got a boo-boo eye.
Two sugars.
I know what to do.
Though Jade's jealousy was bound to cause a few problems, especially when Beck was getting pretty cozy with Alyssa Vaughn.
Let me see if I understand you.
Let's see if you do.
Because you and I date, I can't be friends with other girls.
You can be friends with ugly girls.
You know, Tori, can you come here?
What?
If you were my girlfriend.
Oh, great way to start the question.
Would you be all freaked out that I'm just friends with Alyssa Vaughn?
Who cares what she thinks?
Honestly, I wouldn't love it.
I care what she thinks.
You don't think a girlfriend should distrust her boyfriend?
You know what?
Tell me what.
No, don't tell him what.
We're done.
Jade!
So you're breaking up with me?
No, she's not.
Yeah, I am.
Oh, she is.
You're being ridiculous!
What do you care? I'm not your girlfriend anymore!
Jade instantly regretted breaking up with Beck.
I want Beck back!
But you broke up with Beck.
I know!
But that didn't mean Beck would take her back.
Guess what?
What?
I'm glad Jade and I broke up.
Why?
Because I can't remember the last time she did one nice thing for me.
Oh, come on, didn't you just have a birthday? She didn't get you anything for your birthday?
She got me a can of lemonade.
Yikes. So Jade tried to show that she actually does care about their relationship. And even though it didn't exactly go according to plan...
My dad's in there!
Your dad? Oh my God!
It was enough to show Beck that she loves him.
Tori told me to get you a dog.
Dude! Okay, it was kind of my idea, but I didn't think the dog would bug out like that. I just wanted you to have a dog because I know you've talked about getting one ever since I met you, and I thought that maybe... You love me again.
Who said I stopped?
And they never argued again. Please, then they wouldn't be Beck and Jade.
Come in!
Yeah, come in!
Hi, Beck.
Hi, Allie.
Jade, this is my next door neighbor, Allie.
Hello, Allie.
Thanks for taking care of Sparkles.
Anytime, kiddo.
Your girlfriend's pretty.
I know.
Bye.
See ya. Gonna say you're sorry?
You didn't tell me she was 9.
You didn't give me a chance.
Oh, don't try to turn this around, honey. Listen,
can you guys fight later?
Stay out of this, Tori!
They do love each other.
Yep.
But they just couldn't seem to stop arguing. And it wasn't cute anymore.
Just say A, B, or C!
B!
Maybe it was A.
I don't care!
I'm not happy with our relationship. They're all here. I told you they'd all be here.
Listen, I am sorry that we didn't invite you guys to play.
Tell her why you didn't invite us to play.
All right, we didn't invite you guys to play because you two were always screaming at each other, and it makes everybody feel awkward, it makes Kat faint, and sometimes it makes Robbie cry.
See? We fight so much, even our friends don't want us around.
Tori's not my friend. I only tolerate Robbie. No one likes Trina, and Kat's basically a pet.
Arf!
Beck was asking himself what we were all kind of wondering. Why are they together if they fight all the time?
I'm tired of fighting.
Okay. I'm gonna walk out that door, and I'm gonna count to 10.
If I get to 10 and you're not out there, I'm going home. And we're over. One, two, three, seven, eight, nine, 10.
Let's play some cards.
Beck wasted no time finding someone new and trashing his ex in the process.
You.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
No, you didn't.
Then why can't we kiss?
Because of Jade.
Jade and I broke up.
Yeah, but kissing your friend's ex-boyfriend?
Wait, when are you and Jade friends? Last week, she took your hamburger, she just rubbed it against her bare foot. And she took your spot in the Platinum Music Awards.
Honestly, this was probably the lowest point in their relationship. I mean, how do you come back from something like this? It took a whole waiting room full of strangers to sort this one out.
He used to date this girl, Jade.
My ex-girlfriend.
And she's sort of my friend, so, you know, it'd be weird if he and I dated.
If I could chime in, maybe his ex-girlfriend,
Jade?
Maybe she still likes this boy with the hair.
She kind of walked out on me.
That doesn't mean she ain't still got feelings for you.
Look, I'll always love Jade as a friend, but as a girlfriend, she'd always freak out over every little thing.
Sometimes girls do that, because we get scared inside.
Oh, now, trust me. Jade isn't scared of anything.
You probably just want Beck for yourself.
You know what? You listen to me. And there they are.
Wow, Tori and Beck are here. Who'd have thunk that they'd be... I mean, what a coincidence. Oh, who am I kidding?
Look, Jade, I can explain why Beck
Come
and I...
Come on. How are you going to explain that you're out on a date with her ex-boyfriend?
They broke up. Tori has every right to go out with Beck.
Not really going out. You have no right to be mad at us, because Beck and I are only...
I'm not.
What?
I'm not mad. I thought I was mad, but... I mean, now that I'm here, what do I have to be mad about? We broke up. We're all friends, kinda. I mean, any of us should be able to hang out with whoever we want.
You really okay?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
So it seemed like Jade was actually moving on. Mostly.
What are you all wazzed off about?
These two butt cheeks paid a guy to ask me out on a date.
We were trying to help.
Why do I need your help?
Because guys are scared to ask you out.
That's how I like it.
I got dragged into this.
See, we thought...
You thought.
We thought. But if you got asked out by a guy, you'd be more okay if Beck asked out a girl.
Oh, my God. How many times do I have to say it? I don't care who you date. We broke up. Ask out any girl you want.
See, I said you should have just asked out Meredith.
Meredith? You know what? I don't care. Go out with Meredith. Enjoy her cupcakes.
So Beck could finally go out with someone who wouldn't fight with him constantly.
Are you just gonna agree with everything I say?
Do you want me to agree with everything you say?
No.
Then no.
Okay. I'm gonna go over there.
Awesome.
Hey.
Hey. So, you and Meredith, huh? You guys gonna snoodle?
There will be no snoodling.
What? After everything I've done?
Look, Meredith is nice, too nice. I think I've learned something about myself.
That you're ungrateful to your friend who tried to fix you up with a cute girl?
No, I just think I like dating a girl who, you know, fights back.
You...
I mean, a girl who's got strong opinions, you know, and a big mouth.
Why?
Because it's not easy. Easy's boring.
Okay. I get that. So, who's not boring?
Okay, people, let's heat things up for Jade West. Let's go.
I've missed you.
So what are you gonna do about it?
Trina Vega. When it comes to boys, she has a lot of bad luck. Here are Trina's most memorable crushes and heartbreaks. First up is Robbie, who after a stage kiss fell hard for Trina.
That was fantastic!
That's not your line.
What's not my line?
However, those feelings were definitely not mutual, and she quickly shut him down.
I hope that was soy milk.
Oh. What's the matter with you?
If I drink regular milk, then the gas builds up and up and up and
up. Why did you kiss me?
Oh, because we like each other.
We what?
The audition scene? That kiss?
Robbie, I was playing a part. The script said that my character kisses your character, so that's what happened. That's all that happened.
Would you be willing to convert to Judaism?
Wow, you've got problems.
Next is Lendl, who is a major reason why you shouldn't trust blind dating. Tori tricks Trina into thinking Lendl is a super hot guitar player, but once she arrives to their date, he was far from it.
No! Lendl's a loser! I'm gonna get you, Tori!
After their not-so-romantic dinner, he calls her non-stop and tries to be her boyfriend.
Why can't you answer your own phone?
It's that guy, Lendl. He keeps calling me. Just answer it.
Hello? No, I'm sorry. Trina's...
dead! No. Say I moved to Canada.
She moved to Canada, then died.
But when Tori told him Trina died, he quickly moved on.
This is her sister, Tori? No, I will not go out with you! What is...
Give me my phone! Hey, I'm dead for 10 seconds and you're already hitting on my sister? No, you listen to me, Lendl.
After a lot of heartbreak, Trina finally sets her eyes on hot senior Sean. In order to get close to him, she poses as a pizza delivery girl.
You like pizza?
Sure.
Great! Because there's this new Italian restaurant that just opened, and starting Friday night, they're delivering free pizzas for a whole week.
Oh.
So here, take their number. And here we go, just, yeah. And give them a call this Friday and order yourself a free pizza.
Do they have sweet tea?
Yeah, they do.
How do you know?
Well, I just figured if...
Were you just guessing?
Yeah.
Once she arrives with a pizza, her hopes of dating Sean are crushed when she finds out he has a girlfriend.
So I was thinking maybe I should go inside there with you and the two of us could share the...
What's going on?
Whoa, who's she?
It's my girlfriend.
so when were you gonna tell me about this?
Can I just have my pizza?
Oh, your pizza. Yeah, you want your pizza. Okay, yeah, sure. Let me just get that for you, huh? We're over!
It's no secret that Trina has a major crush on Beck, and she is not afraid to show it.
You guys might break up, because I'm not dating anyone, and I've always thought that Beck and I would make the perfect...
However, when she spreads a rumor that Beck asked her out, he comes up with a way to get revenge.
Boy, don't fight over me! Boy, come on!
Look out, look out! Audrey, no!
Hey.
Don't look! It's this guy! Ah!
Dad, come quick! They're killing each other! Andre started hitting Robbie with the tea kettle.
What's going on?
We're doing a puppet show.
I am the king.
I'm the queen. And I'm the little pussycat.
Mom. But they were just, I swear, I saw them in there and they were just...
Just promise me when you go to college, it'll be someplace far, far away.
Trina! Did you learn your lesson?
About telling lies!
Even though he shot her down multiple times, Trina was not going to let this crush go without a fight.
No!
Ah!
Trina!
Stop!
Come on! Just give me a chance!
Stop!
Just
get off!
One day!
No!
You have to understand, I'm a really fun girl!
No, you're not!
You're so good-looking!
What are you doing?
Boy.
Stop! Stop!
Stop!
And finally, there was Seth. Even though we never actually see him, Cat Valentine, the most cheerful student at Hollywood Arts. When Cat isn't rocking the stage or hanging with her BFFs, she's been known to have a boyfriend or two. Here's the full story of Cat Valentine's relationships. First, there was Daniel, AKA Danny.
Daniel!
Hey, Ben.
This is the guy I've been telling you about. My boyfriend.
Turns out, Kat's new boyfriend, Daniel, was actually Tori's old boyfriend, Danny.
Okay, wait, so you and Tori were like...
Girlfriend.
Boyfriend.
So...
Please, don't feel weird about this.
You really shouldn't. I mean, we broke up a year ago.
Yeah, it's been a year.
It's only been 11 months.
What difference does it make?
Forget it! The point is, I'm totally cool with you guys dating.
And I'm totally cool that you two are friends.
Well, okay then. It's all happy.
Hey.
I'm bored now.
I apologize for... her.
So how did you guys meet? Hey, do you guys want to go... Yeah. Okay.
With Danny back in the picture, Tori gets a little jealous.
What the hell, boys?
You got cheese in our hair!
Tori!
Why did you do that?
I don't know. I just...
And she may have kissed Danny in front of Kat.
I mean, are you maybe still into me?
No, not at all. And I love Kat. She's like the sweetest thing ever. And I'm psyched you guys are going out. I guess it's just...
Danny make up, and Kat may have gotten a little revenge on Tori.
I'm sorry! And I'm not just saying I'm sorry, I'm really, really, seriously sorry.
You sprayed cheese on me and then kissed my boyfriend.
Yeah. Yeah, I did.
Why would you be mean to me?
I don't know. Maybe I did still have a few tiny little feelings left for Danny. And maybe that's why I went a little crazy. Seeing you two being all mushy together.
You could have just talked to me about it.
I know. What I did was terrible and awful and immature, and you have every right to be furious with me. I swear, Kat, if I were you, I'd just punch me right in the face.
Ow!
Kat!
What?
You just punched me in the face!
You said to.
I know, but that's just something people say. Ow!
Does it hurt?
A lot. I think my nose may be broken.
Well, now I feel all bad.
Don't. I deserved it. Feel better?
I think so.
I'm sorry. Will you take me to a hospital now?
Sure.
Thank you.
Okay, fast forward to Evan.
What?
You're just really pretty.
Oh. Huh.
Sorry, I probably shouldn't have said that.
No, it's okay. I love compliments.
Well, you want to sit down with me? Maybe talk a little bit?
I don't know if I should. Okay.
Wait, don't you want to go hit the bathroom first?
No, you seem way more fun than a bathroom.
Evan and Kat hit it off. But only because he thought she was blonde.
You never told him you were wearing a wig?
I forgot. What if he hates redheaded girls?
He won't.
You're being silly.
What's this boy's name?
Evan. I forget his last name. It rhymes with Smith.
Could it be Smith?
That's it! God, it's been killing me. When he sees how I really look, he's gonna be disappointed. And
that doesn't! Katarina Valentine, I will not sit here anymore and listen to you talk bad about yourself. You're adorable. Any guy would be lucky as cheese to go out with you.
Thanks, Robbie. That's really sweet, but you don't know how guys think.
Okay. Good day!
Jade, tell Kat that when this boy sees her pretty red hair tonight, he's gonna like her even more.
Can't do that.
Why not?
Because I'm looking at Evan's splash face page and scrolling through pics of his ex-girlfriends. Blonde. Whoa, ugly blonde. Blonde. Oh, and his blue-eyed dog with blonde fur. I'm thinking Evan goes for blondes.
Oh, that doesn't mean anything. What are his likes and dislikes?
Likes sushi, video games, girls with blonde hair and blue eyes.
Dislikes?
People who pretend to be something they're not.
Oh, no!
Kat comes clean, and while she may lose Evan...
This is me.
Well, you're beautiful.
I am?
Totally. But I'm really into blondes. Later.
There's still someone who sees the real Kat and thinks she's swell.
I'll be the Jagger to your Richards, the Captain Kirk to your Picard. If you're a molten lava room, I'll be the one inept guard. We go together like pastrami on rye, like watching Titanic and trying not to cry. We go together like a parade to confetti, and later if you're hungry, I'll make you some spaghetti.
Would there be meatballs?
There would. Swell.
Hey, what if I just dye my hair blonde?
The next guy to enter Kat's life is Beck's friend Moose. He's from Canada.
He sure is.
But it looks like she may have some competition for Moose's attention.
Moose? I didn't know you were gonna be here.
I didn't know you were a hockey fan.
Oh, yeah, I've been a hockey fan for a long time. See? My name's on the back.
You can't have a shirt like this made overnight.
You can, Sol.
You just go to that all-night shirt shop on Western and tell them you...
Looky what I got.
Tickets to tonight's Kings game?
Uh-huh. Okay, she is not an LA Kings fan.
She's faking.
Well, I am not faking.
I love hockey. I've been a Kings fan ever since they picked Anze Kopitar in the first round of the 2005 NHL draft.
Yeah, that totally turned the team around.
Right around.
Hey, could you believe that triple overtime game last year against Vancouver?
So, you like my dress and my scissors from your favorite movie?
Oh my gosh. Who wants a hamburger? Hamburger.
The one guy Kat doesn't have to compete for? Robbie Shapiro. Kat and Robbie definitely had a spark at the cow-wow dance.
Thanks for petting my head bump.
Can I tell you a secret?
Sure.
Until Kat up and ran away. Here's someone she didn't run away from, Freddie Benson. Kat invites Freddie over to make Sam jealous, and they instantly hit it off.
I didn't say anything funny.
What the? Is that?
No way.
What, Kat?
No, it's for... just come with me.
Oh, Freddie. Oh, look who's here.
Sam, there you are. Hi.
What are you doing? What is happening here?
See, I came down to L.A. because I thought you got run over by...
Oh, Freddie, this is my friend Jade. Jade, how cute is my new friend Freddie?
Yeah, he's a pretty little chunk of boy.
Well, this is awkward.
Your entire life is awkward. You should be used to it by now.
She makes a good point.
Until Robbie shows up singing for Sam.
Sounds like
you're swell.
Robbie Shapiro!
So not swell, Robbie.
Robbie is in love with me.
So? Freddie's in love with me.
Now, wait a second. If you're so in love with Sam, then why have you been running around Los Angeles fadoodling with Kat?
I haven't fadoodled with Kat.
You could have if you wanted to.
Kat and Sam continue to fight over the guys, but there's a little accident.
Kat, no!
Kat! Here she comes! She's gonna...
In the end, Kat and Robbie agree to go on a date.
Kat! When my wounds heal, maybe you and I can hang out. Just the two of us.
Here's the full story of Beck and Tori. Tori and Beck instantly connected on Tori's first day at Hollywood Arts.
Head feels dizzy.
I know what'll make you feel better.
Jumping jacks?
Kiss me.
Let's do it.
This school.
But Beck and Jade were already dating, so just friends it is. Tori even brought Bade back together.
Tori told me to get you a dog.
Dude!
Okay, it was kind of my idea, but I didn't think the dog would bug out like that. I just wanted you to have a dog because I know you've talked about getting one ever since I met you, and I thought that maybe... You love me again.
Who said I stopped?
I ruined the moment.
It's cool, and I really do owe you.
But were they just friends? I mean, Beck fell off a balcony for Tori.
It's okay. I got this.
Wait, what are you?
Shh, wait here.
And Tori jumped into a fight to save Beck.
Beck! Leave him alone! What are you doing?
are you doing?
That guy was beating up Beck!
I took a class with him last summer.
Well, it looked like he was hurting you. Why do you care?
Plus all those on-stage romances.
For you, I would wait 1,000 years.
But that's so many!
I know I don't have much to offer, but I do love you.
Because I'm beautiful?
I don't love you because you're beautiful. You're beautiful because I love you.
Whoa.
And then Beck and Jade split up.
I'm tired of fighting.
Okay. I'm gonna walk out that door, and I'm gonna count to 10.
Don't forget 3. Some people forget it.
If I get to 10 and you're not out there, I'm going home. And we're over. 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10.
It finally seemed like Bori's time to shine.
You don't look too happy.
Not.
Why?
Because I just wish that I could tell everyone.
That it's all an act? That those people are making you dress and act like a jerk?
How did you know?
Because you're Tori. You wouldn't act like that unless someone was making you.
Oh my God, you have no idea how happy I am that you know the truth! But I didn't tell you. I never told you I was faking. You guessed it!
Now why don't you just stop?
I don't know. I'm scared.
Listen. Just tell Mason Thornsmith that you're not gonna play his little game anymore.
What?
The world needs to see who you really are. Because you're awesome.
I gotta go.
Okay, later.
School stuff. Bye.
So close, but there's still a chance for Bori.
I mean, if I'm gonna be successful, I want it to be because of my talent, not for throwing tantrums and wearing meat hats.
Can't you be famous for your music and wear a meat hat?
Seriously, meat. Whenever you want. Just right out of your hat.
Simple as that.
So.
Yeah. You.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry.
I didn't mean to.
No, you didn't. You.
Then why can't we kiss?
Because of Jade.
Jade and I broke up.
Kat Valentine, Jade West. This duo may be sweet and sour, but put them together and their friendship is iconic. This is the story of Jade and Kat's friendship.
Yay, we're hanging out together.
No!
Okay, so let's start from the beginning. Jade picks Kat first for their acting exercise, which is super exciting.
Kat, Eli, Beck. And Tori.
But nothing is more exciting than revenge. And Kat and Jade definitely get theirs after losing a competition to a group of girls.
Tonight's winners are Haley and Tara!
The two work together and are able to trick them, totally winning.
All those for Haley and Tara!
All those for Louise Norda.
But they don't always win. Like when Kat accidentally shocks Jade. Totally an accident.
Kat! You just shocked me! I'm sorry!
But Kat does make it up to her when she was assigned to be Jade's secret Santa.
Hi! Secret Santa time!
Kat went above and beyond with her gift and gave Jade probably the best and scariest Secret Santa gift ever.
Scissors.
They're special scissors.
Okay.
They're from a real movie.
I cannot believe you got me these. What movie were they used in? Scissoring.
And while the two may have had their ups and downs, with plenty of insults from Jade thrown in.
If someone was pushed off this catwalk and they landed on the floor really hard, do you think they'd live?
Why are you asking that?
No reason.
They do come together when it counts, especially after Jade and Beck break up.
Why? What are you doing Saturday night?
Oh, what? What, you think because Beck and I broke up, I don't have anything to do Saturday night?
No, I never said
I've got
that.
A lot of things I'm gonna do. Like, tons.
Okay.
I mean, if you want me to cancel my plans and come hang out with you while you dog sit, then fine.
Kat lets Jade dog sit with her. And even though some things may have gone haywire, Jade comes through for Kat in the end.
I'm so sorry about your guitar and your lamp and your table.
That's all right. It's not your fault.
But
Kat! Mr. Gibbons isn't mad at us because he knows the earthquake caused all this damage.
But that isn't the only time. Jade also took time out to help drive Kat to her favorite actress's house, even though she may have done it for her own reasons.
If my brother lets us borrow his car, will you drive Tori and me to an old lady's house after school?
No.
Wait!
Please? Kat's really sad because this actress passed away last night and— Whoa, she passed away just last night?
Yeah.
Then yeah. Yeah, I'll drive you guys to her house.
Why'd you change your mind?
Because it's been less than 24 hours, which means her spirit is still lingering. So I'll be able to breathe in the fumes of her soul.
And Kat repays the favor when she helps Jade get ready for the rehearsals for the Platinum Music Awards.
We're backstage at the Boomerang Theater.
Kat, you don't have to lie. It's okay if you're with Jade helping her get ready for the show tomorrow night.
You sure you're not mad at me?
I'm sure.
Proving she was a true BFF. But even your best friend can make some mistakes, like accidentally waxing your eyebrows off.
Jade asked me to make her eyebrows look nice, so I tried to wax them, but when I took the wax strips off, there was, a problem.
My eyebrows are gone!
No, they're not! I told you, they're right here!
But Jade made sure to make it even. Maybe even taking it a little too far.
I fell asleep during study hall. Jade found me.
But the duo don't hold this against each other and still hang out a lot, like having a girls' night out.
Do you want to do something fun with me tomorrow night?
Sure. What?
I don't know. I figured you'd pick because you're bossy.
Don't say I'm bossy!
Which may have involved some hijinks and following Tori and Beck.
So where are you guys right now?
We're at some food truck near Melrose and La Brea.
Melrose and La Brea, okay.
Hey, so what are you up to tonight?
Bye!
Melrose and La Brea, here we come.
But the real trouble comes when Moose comes to town. Kat and Jade fight for Moose's attention.
And look, these are the actual scissors from the movie.
Oh my God, that is so cool.
I gave her those.
Yeah, and look how sharp they are.
Flowers.
But they won't let a boy get in the way of their friendship.
No offense, but I like Canadian girls.
Why?
They like hockey. You know, for real. They're bigger. And they're just less weird than Hollywood girls.
Especially when Kat could possibly be leaving Hollywood Arts. When Jade finds Kat sleeping in the school, she feels really bad.
You ran away?
Uh-huh. I live here now.
Oh, come on. You have to have some other relative you can live with.
What about your grandmother?
Yeah, what do you call her? Nona?
I would love to live with my Nona, but she moved away to Italy.
And helps find a way for Kat to stay, even though it turns out she wasn't going far.
Kat, grab your stuff. We're going for a ride.
To where?
To your grandmother's apartment.
But I told you, she moved to Italy.
No, I called your parents. Your Nona moved to Venice.
Right. That's in Italy. I looked it up.
Venice, California. It's 12 miles from here.
Well, that explains why I saw her at the mall last weekend. You think she'd let me move in with her in Venice of America?
Yes, your parents talked to Nona, and she'd love to have you come live with her.
And when Jade visits Kat for a school project, she makes a new friend, which totally makes Kat jealous.
Hey, sup?
Sup? What's up, biz? Looks like you guys forgot to invite me to your little get-together.
No, we were just about to text you.
Just about?
I also noticed I wasn't invited to go with you guys to the movies last night either.
It was a horror movie. You hate horror movies.
So, I hate spiders too. But if a spider was having a birthday party, I could swing by for some cake.
But Kat has no need to worry because Jade always has her back when she isn't scheming or insulting someone. And there you have it. Even though there may be a little jealousy here and there, insults courtesy of Jade, of course, and an accidental eyebrow waxing, Kat Valentine and Jade West remain friends through it all. They're there to help each other when it's needed and to sing some awesome songs together. This unlikely duo is truly sour and sweet, but we wouldn't have it any other way. Tori Vega. We all know she loved to make it shine, but she also had a few love interests while at Hollywood Arts. Here are Tori's most memorable relationships. Let's start off with the first boy who caught her eye, Beck.
It's cool.
No, it's... I here. I think it's coming out.
You might be making it worse, actually.
Right away, the two had a connection.
I know it'll make you feel better.
Jumping jacks?
Kiss me.
Let's do it.
However, Beck was dating Jade, making them just friends for now. Next is Tori's ex, Daniel.
Danny!
Hey! You go to school here?
Yeah. You know I love Sherwood.
Right, but I just didn't know where... I mean, isn't this school for, like, really talented kids who... I did not mean...
No, keep talking. You're doing great.
Who happened to be Kat's new boyfriend.
This is the guy I've been telling you about. My boyfriend.
Oh.
Daniel, these are my friends, Beck, Jade, and that's Tori.
Yeah, we've met.
Really? You know Daniel?
Oh, she knows Daniel.
It seemed as though she wasn't totally over him. But after a minor overreaction...
What the hell, boys? You got cheese in our hair!
Tori!
Why did you do that?
I don't know. I just...
Daniel kissed Tori when she tried to apologize.
No!
In the end, she admitted she didn't really have feelings for him, and it was jealousy that got the better of her. Then there was super cute Ryder Daniels. It seemed like everything was going great when he asked Tori to go out with him.
So, I was wondering if maybe you...
Look, I really can't sing a duet with you.
No, that's not what I was gonna ask you.
It's not?
I was gonna see if maybe you wanted to, you know, go out. Or I should probably just...
No! Wait! I'd love to go out sometime. And wow, your arm is hard.
Thanks. So we'll grab sushi or something.
Yes. I mean, yes. Yes, I want to do that.
Trina quickly warned her of his possible shady motives.
I'm gonna surprise my date. Ryder Daniels.
Ryder, senior guy, super hot.
Yeah.
Be careful.
Why?
He dates lots of girls. You know my friend Lindsay?
Lindsay doesn't like you.
So, I know her. Anyway, she went out with Ryder last year, and he totally broke her heart.
He dumped her?
Like, with no warning, just boom, over.
After getting caught snooping through his phone, she begged for another chance, and the two decided to perform a duet at the Full Moon Jam.
I get so scared to sing alone.
Well, maybe we could do a song together. A little, duet action? Mm.
That sounds nice. You make me feel safe.
However, Tori found out that the rumors were true.
So he's just using me to get a good grade?
Sorry, Tori.
You must feel pretty stupid right now.
But with the help of her friends, she was able to create the perfect revenge.
Hey, you guys.
Hi.
Okay, this is a little song for the ladies, especially for the ones who know my friend Ryder.
My mic's not working.
Bummer. Let's go, Andre.
Andre? What song is this?
Just listen. I think you'll hate it.
You had it all the day you told me you want me. I had it all, but let you fool me completely. Yeah, I was so stupid to give you all my attention. Cause the way you played me exposed your true intentions.
Hey, one day!
From one shady boy to the next, she started dating Steven, who also was dating Carly Shay from iCarly. He even gave her the same charm bracelet he gave Carly, with a minor typo.
When he gave you yours, did he say, it's one of a kind, just like you? At least he had mine engraved to Carly and yours to Tori.
Yeah, at least.
Wait. Mine says to Topi. You didn't even notice they got the engraving wrong.
Unless he's dating a third girl named Topi.
After finding out about his two-timing ways, Tori used their 100-day kiss as a perfect moment to get back at him.
Hi, Steven!
What is this?
This is iCarly! Boyfriend Steven.
Ex?
He's also her ex-boyfriend.
Ex?
Yes, ex, meaning
not anymore.
Just when we thought Bori was forever in the friend zone, Thak and Tori almost kiss.
Cause I don't want to be. Cause I just wish that I could tell everyone.
That it's all an act? That those people are making you dress and act like a jerk?
How did you know?
Because you're Tori. You wouldn't act like that unless someone was making you.
Oh my God, you have no idea how happy I am that you know the truth! But I didn't tell you. I never told you I was faking. You guessed it!
Okay. Now why don't you just stop?
Because if I don't keep acting like a bad girl obnoxious rock star, they might drop me from the show.
The show is in 2 days. I can't fire you.
I don't know. I'm scared.
Listen, just tell Mason Thornsmith that you're not gonna play his little game anymore.
What?
The world needs to see who you really are. Because you're awesome.
Hi.
I gotta go.
Okay, later.
School stuff.
Bye.
And they almost kiss again.
So.
Yeah. You.
I'm sorry.
No. I'm sorry.
I didn't mean to.
No, you didn't. You.
Then why can't we kiss?
Because of Jade.
Jade and I broke up.
Yeah, but kissing your friend's ex-boyfriend?
Wait. When are you and Jade friends?
Last week, she took your hamburger. She just rubbed it against her bare foot.
What? I ate feet meat?
As if it wasn't already awkward, the two tried to deny their connection and go on an opposite date.
Busy? We were just talking about the museum.
Dude, I can't go with just you.
Why not?
Because if it's just the two of us, then it's like a date.
All right, I get it. You don't want to go on a date. So we'll do the opposite of a date.
Opposite?
We won't dress nice, we'll eat terrible food, and we'll do something unfun. Then it's not a date. It's just us hanging out.
Yeah, it's not a date. It's like an opposite date.
See you at 7.
I am not looking forward to it.
But in the end, Tori was a true friend and brought Jade and Beck back together. Here's the full story of Robbie and Kat. From the very beginning, there was something going on with Kat and Robbie.
You're still on that?
She loves me.
It was a stage kiss. She was acting.
You didn't feel the kiss.
A girl can't fake that kind of heat. I don't care if she tells me 1,000 times that it didn't mean anything because...
See?
I want you to meet my parents.
So Robbie was definitely into Kat. But was Kat into Robbie?
I don't know if maybe, you know, maybe you want to go to the prom with me? Would you?
Oh, Robbie, I'd love to go to the prom with you, but another boy already asked me.
Really? Who?
Tug.
Tug?
Yeah, he goes to Burbank High. He's a football player. Thanks for asking me, though.
Thanks for responding. I wish I asked her before Tug did.
Dude, you've been lied to. Kat doesn't have a date to the prom.
She said she does.
Man, no one's named Tug.
She lied to me. Weird, I still don't see your date anywhere. Where is Tug?
Well, he was standing next to a candle and his jacket caught on fire.
If you didn't want to go to this prom with me, you could have just said so.
It's not that I didn't
want to make up lies about some fake football player named Tug with a spinning hat and a jacket that caught on fire.
But I'm not lying.
Good night.
No, Robbie, I'm...
I said good night.
I think I put my jacket out.
After Kat rejected him, Robbie somehow liked her more. Like, a lot more.
Where'd you get those standees of Kat?
You know, I just, brought them from home.
Why do you have...
I'm the tutor, and I don't like to talk about things I do at my house.
Sorry.
Hi. How's a tutoring session go?
These aren't mine. I just want... Okay, they are mine, but I only made them.
Cardboard cutouts of your crush? Nope, not creepy at all. But behind all that, it seemed like Robbie had genuine feelings for Kat. He knew just what to get her for Secret Santa.
Calling Kat Valentine.
I'm Kat Valentine. Who's calling?
Your Secret Santa.
Oh my God, yay!
And your Christmas present is... your very own cotton candy machine! That's right, this man, Larry Stein, will follow you around all week and give you all the cotton candy you want.
Oh my God, Robbie! Thank you! This is the best Christmas present ever! Look, everyone! Robbie got me a cotton candy machine with a man!
Kat never took him seriously, though.
Kat's bugging because she and that guy Evan really hit it off last night, but... he thinks that she has blonde hair and blue eyes. You never told him you were wearing a wig?
I forgot. What if he hates redheaded girls?
He won't.
You're being silly.
When he sees how I really look, he's gonna be disappointed. And
that doesn't! Katarina Valentine, I will not sit here anymore and listen to you talk bad about yourself. You're adorable. Any guy would be lucky as cheese to go out with you.
Thanks, Robbie. That's really sweet, but you don't know how guys think.
Okay. Good day!
Like, can it be any more obvious? Robbie adores her.
Hey.
Hi.
I think that Evan guy is really dumb for not seeing how great you are.
You want to hear the new song I've been working on?
I don't know if I'm in the mood to listen.
Please?
Okay.
I think you're swell. I think you're swell. You're the nugget in my chicken, make the peanuts in my butter. Adding fiber to our diets, beneficial for each other. Your piece of dental floss, and I am the teeth. You're Aretha Franklin, I'm R-E-S-P-E-C-T. I love you like a cop's marathon on TV. I love you more than the original Star Wars trilogy. You're a guitar, and I'm the strings like a jet ski in the water. You're New York, I'm the buildings. You're my mother, I'm your father. And I think you're swell. And every day when you're walking down the street is like every other day because you're constantly walking down the street. And every day I'm only thinking about you and a bunch of other important things, but primarily you. And that's true, because I think you're swell. I think you're swell. I'll be the Jagger to your Richards, the Captain Kirk to your Picard. If you're a molten lava room, I'll be the one inept guard. We go together like pastrami on rye, like watching Titanic and trying not to cry. We go together like a parade to confetti. And later, if you're hungry, I'll make you some spaghetti.
Would there be meatballs?
There would. And I think you're swell. I think you're swell. And I think you're swell.
Hey, what if I just dye my hair blonde?
Okay, it's easy to say that Kat totally missed the point, but maybe she just didn't feel the same way.
Okay, first of all, she's not my girl.
Unless you want to be.
I'm good. Well, Robbie texted me last night saying he wants to talk to me, and I know he's gonna ask me to be his date.
Gross.
Don't say gross, I like Robbie.
So, go to the dance with him.
No, gross.
You just said that
Look,
you
Robbie's one of my best friends. It'll be weird if I'm his date to a dance.
Well, think fast, because here he comes.
Hi. Listen.
Why?
I'm gonna go.
No!
I just wanted to ask you something.
Oh, you want to know my favorite vice president of all time? Easy, Dick Cheney.
No, I just wanted to ask you, you know the cow-wow dance that's happening later this week?
No.
Hello. Hey, you don't have to keep running away from me. I already asked Gabriella to be my date to the cow-wow.
Gabriella?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what'd she say?
She said, see.
That means yes.
I know. I looked it up.
Well, yay. You got yourself a pretty girl to take to the cow-wow.
Yeah. Well, I just wanted to let you know you don't have to run away from me anymore.
Thanks, Robbie.
See you in class.
Okay. Gabriella.
Wait, did I miss something? Please, explain.
I thought you told Robbie you didn't want to be his date tonight.
So? That doesn't make it okay for him to bring another girl.
So, you don't want to be Robbie's date?
And you don't want Robbie to bring another date?
Yes. Thank you.
That was so unhelpful. But it seems like a classic case of you don't know what you've got till it's gone, mixed with a hint of use someone else to make your crush jealous.
You think Kat's trying to make Robbie jealous?
Wow! Sinjin, you're such a good dancer! So much better than Robbie!
But in a weird way, it did bring Robbie back.
Oh!
Oh, I'm so sorry!
Did you see that?
You feeling okay?
Yeah, just got a little head on my bump.
Okay, everyone, let Kat have some air.
Wait, will you stay with me?
Why me?
Because I want you to stay with me till I feel better.
Okay.
Unless you want to go be with your dumb date.
Nah. I think she likes Sinjin.
Love will keep us together.
I'm sorry I got kicked in your head.
Sorry I didn't come with you to the dance in the first place.
Is my hand sweaty?
Yeah. It feels like a fish. Thanks for petting my head bump.
Can I tell you a secret?
Sure.
Okay, are they together or not? Because sometimes they act like a couple, but plot twist, Robbie and Sam Pocket start hanging out.
Robbie Shapiro!
Oh, Kat, you're back. Robbie was just singing me a little song he wrote called...
I know what it's called. He wrote that song for me.
Kat!
I'm swell, me! He sang that to me over a year ago.
Well, he's singing it to me now.
Robbie, I thought you and me had something special.
Well, it seems like you've got something special with a lot of fellas.
Well, you flirted with Robbie right in front of my face.
Oh, you mean like this? That was some tasty Robbie.
One tuna jump later, though.
Kat, when my wounds heal, maybe you and I can hang out. Just the two of us.
Would there be meatballs?
There would.
KK.
Tori, Jade, Tori and Jade, Jory, whatever you want to call them. These frenemies have seen their fair share of ups and downs.
Wait, are we friends? We're not even friends!
Here's the full story of how Jade and Tori became best frenemies.
And I thought we were just starting to be friends.
Let's kick it back to the beginning, when Jade and Tori first met. It wasn't exactly an ideal start to a friendship, and Tori would learn that the last thing anyone should do is rub Jade the wrong way.
Why are you rubbing my boyfriend? I spilled coffee on...
Get away from him!
Jade's jealousy got the best of her, which caused some serious tension between Tori and Jade. But what better way to cool the heat than with a big old cup of iced coffee?
What's the prob? Dog.
Woof. That was totally uncalled for. Tori wouldn't let a little caffeine ruin her new high school experience, though. Instead, she decided to hit Jade where it really hurt.
Kiss me.
Let's do it.
The lines were drawn, and these two would continue down frenemy lane.
I can't wait for our fight. Scene.
When Jade and Tori were chosen as partners to act in a fight scene, things inevitably went south.
Ow!
Let me see.
You okay? No, Tori hit me in the face, for real.
No, I didn't.
Tell that to my bloody eye.
I don't know. Looked a little suspicious, don't you think? Probably because Tori never actually hit Jade. Shocker. Either way, Tori still had to pay for her actions, even if she didn't really do them.
So, you're just gonna let me get away with it? You took detention and a lower grade, and you're scraping crusty pudding off the wall on a Friday night just so I won't get in trouble?
Pretty much.
Well, you can't be nice to me when I've been mean to you. That's not how it works.
Well, then try being nice to me sometime. Maybe that'll work. Now, go play. I gotta scrape this onion dip off the wall.
Or onion pus.
When all hope seemed lost, Jade surprised us all by putting the friend in frenemy. The back and forth between these two would continue, with Tori constantly coming to Jade's aid. We saw it first when Jade and Beck broke up, with Tori coming to the rescue and saving the relationship.
You love me again.
I said I stopped.
Aww.
Then we saw it again when Jade needed help getting her play produced.
How much do you think it really cost to produce your play?
I don't know, $2,000-$3,000?
Okay, well then it shouldn't be that hard to find someone to put up the money.
You'd really find me someone to put up the money to produce my play?
I meant the... Hey! Did she not say? It shouldn't be that hard to find someone to put up the money.
Jesus. Something like that. Sure.
So you'll do that, right? Sure. Good.
Jade, who's usually ungrateful when it comes to Tori's kindness, couldn't resist feeling the love after getting her dad's approval on her play, all because of Tori.
I thought it was excellent.
Thanks. Anything else?
Would you please take that jewelry out of your face?
No.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, get what you wanted?
Mm-hmm. I've never seen him look that happy before.
Come on. Give Tori a squeeze.
A truly groundbreaking moment in this duo's dynamic. It was a hug the entire world embraced. But naturally, it didn't last very long.
I'm gonna count to 10, and then I'm gonna...
You're ever so welcome!
I don't talk like that!
Look. I'm sure it can be argued that Jade was just trying to help Tori conquer her fear of falling. But did that push seem a little too diabolical? Especially with Jade's jealousy looming in the dark, ready to spark at any moment.
Did you get the lead?
I don't think she got it.
So, who's playing Susie?
Yikes. This definitely wouldn't go over well with Jade, especially since she was cast as Tori's understudy.
What's an understudy? Oh, man.
An understudy is like a backup actor.
So if you get sick or something, your understudy takes over for your part in the play.
Yeah. Yeah, if you get sick, or go missing, or get hit by a bus!
Sure, Tori and Jade are frenemies, but Jade wouldn't go as far as physically harming Tori in any way, right? Or perhaps that earlier pushing premonition was onto something.
I wonder who would have sent me flowers.
Oh, Tori, those are bush daisies!
What's up?
I am way allergic to bush daisies. Like, if I get anywhere near them, my whole face starts swelling up and I start sweating and shaking.
Well, who would have sent you bush daisies?
I don't know. Or maybe I do. How did you know I was allergic to bush daisies?
I do my research.
You looked up my medical records?
I'll answer that right after you stick your face in those bush daisies.
Listen to me. I'm doing this play. I auditioned, I got the lead, and I'm doing it. I don't care what you do.
All right.
Wow, that's some next level enemy stuff. And for a while, it seemed as though that's how Jory would stay.
Jade is a mean, vicious person with deep psychological problems.
The tension between these frenemies had reached a boiling point. But what's a true friendship without its ups and downs? When Tori and Jade were cast in a play as husband and wife, they had no choice but to get along.
I guess some people might say that from certain angles, you're pretty.
You could say I'm pretty.
You are pretty.
Though forced together, Tori and Jade were starting to see eye to eye. Just in time, too.
I bet we got us a couple of songbirds here, huh?
You guys sing songs?
Sing us a song.
Yeah, we want to hear a little songy song action.
They want to hear a little songy song action.
I am not your missing link. Let me tell you what I think. I think you could use a mint. Take a hint, take a hint.
Awesome is it seeing Tori and Jade come together despite their differences, and it would only get better once Jade finally realized just how much Tori had her back.
Oh, you
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. No, you didn't. You.
Then why can't we kiss?
Because of Jade.
Jade and I broke up.
Yeah, but kissing your friend's ex-boyfriend?
Wait. Since when are you and Jade friends?
Last week, she took your hamburger. She just rubbed it against her bare foot.
What? Are you feet meat?
And she took your spot in the Platinum Music Awards.
Look, I mean, I guess Jade and I aren't really friends, but we're kind of friends, I think. And kissing her ex-boyfriend? I can't do that to a friend.
After seeing this act of courage and loyalty, Jade hung up her jealousy and decided to give Tori a chance, allowing these frenemies to become friends.
Everyone else was coming to cheer you on, so I figured I would too. And you look way better in that than I would have.
This isn't right.
Yeah, it is a little tight around
you. No. Not the stupid outfit, this. Me.
I don't. This is supposed to be your night. This was your big chance, so for me to go out there and I can't do that to a friend. Or even to you.
From then on out, Jade and Tori continued down the path of friendship with a few classic friendly jabs here and there.
I wasn't done talking!
I was done listening.
These frenemies have been through the ringer, but at the end of the day, their bond is so strong, not even a pair of scissors can tear Jory apart, no matter how hard they might try.
Do you have your new scissors with you?
No.
Don't be shy. Those are my old scissors. Okay, so what do you want?
Merry Christmas.
You're my secret Santa?
Ho, ho.
Ho. So, what's my gift?
An idea for a present to give to Andre.
You have an idea?
A perfect one.
Awesome. Tell me.
Beg me.